This is Master Ayud.
I teach to every day child free.
In the country of Pakistan, roughly 23 million children are illiterate. That's the same amount of people as Australia. Kids are seen living on the streets, selling anything they can get their hands on to support themselves and their families, often making less than $2 a day. But this one 61-year-old man in the capital of Islamabad is making a difference, and if we all follow his lead, then an education revolution is bound to help Pakistan prosper. It all started 37 years ago in 1982.
Where did you get the idea to start teaching kids?
How did you get the idea to start teaching kids? I was a fireman and I would go to any hand.
He was a firefighter and there were a lot of incidents. So he saw children crying, children in pain, children suffering. So he realized that most of the children, they were working, so child labor. And he realized that they were not going to school.
So he started with one kid, teaching him basic studies in a local park. One kid led to two, which led to dozens, hundreds. And now Master Ayud has taught tens of thousands of kids on his own time and on his own dime.
How many years have you been learning here?
10 years.
Since you were 7 years old?
I came here 14 years ago.
And what do you like mostly about Master Ayud?
He's very kind and loving.
He's a very nice person. I am very inspired from his teaching system.
And what do you want to do when you grow up? What kind of job?
I will be teaching here. I will teach here.
That's what you want to do? Amazing. Is this their only schooling and they just come at however many hours they want?
So he has two kind of children coming. One who are working full time and they have no money and no time to go to school. And then the second are from poor family who go to government school but they do not have extra money to pay for the tuition because tuition in Pakistan is very expensive.
What's the most rewarding part about your job?
Okay, the most satisfaction that he get is when he teaches children that they can serve their country and so they can go to Pakistan Army, they can become engineers, doctors or firefighters or whatever job and they can serve their country.
I am an office assistant in a multinational company, oil and gas development, China National Petroleum Company.
The first student he taught in 1982 is working for the Ministry of Education.
So what subjects do you teach?
English, mathematics, Urdu, Islamiyat, science, all the schools, Pakistan schools.
So where do you get the supplies?
Jo gareeb gurba bachche hain, wo to main aap leke aata hoon.
Okay, so he's saying that normally he buys everything himself for the unprivileged ones, but those who can afford to buy books and pencils, they buy it and they bring it. If somebody wants to give, he just takes it, accepts it. But he doesn't ask for any help to anybody.
My love to Pakistan. My love to his student.
Is the government helping you at all?
No.
The government doesn't help him, but he has been recognized for his work. He has gotten gold medals. He has got medals from the Queen Elizabeth. He has been awarded from the civil defense, from the firefighters.
When do you plan on stopping, or do you ever plan?
I will keep doing this until I die.
Yeah. So Master, you've told me that he lives directly across the street from the school, from the park.
Yes.
So we're now walking right to his house.
So we are now entering the home, his home.
Okay, one of his students, he did bachelor's and then he got him a computer certification so he can teach the children.
Okay, these are Islamic books, these are prophetic books.
This is in his house.
Education is a growing issue nationwide that needs some attention. It needs structuring. What Master Ayud is doing has never been done before. His dedication and his big heart shines.
One, two, three.
And it's been an absolute pleasure to see the impact that he's making on so many people's lives.
Inshallah, my students, next class to kamyab is Pakistan.
Pakistan!
Zindabad!
Pakistan!
Zindabad!
Pakistan!
Zindabad!
Zindabad!
Zindabad! He
he just said that this year, 2018 and 2019 academic year, he had 230 students. Only three of them failed. One, because he was so sick and he couldn't go because of his absence. Second, the girl was too poor to come to him. And the third one was also poor and couldn't come on time.
Everybody else?
Yes, everybody else passed.